We have a Medeco M3 here. We're gonna try to pick. Here is the key. You can see the angled cuts there. You can see this bar here pushes on the slider, which helps engage the sidebar inside the lock. So the key works. I'm gonna pick this counterclockwise, which seems to work out best for me. On this particular lock, it doesn't seem like going counterclockwise engages the entire sidebar because of that slider. So I may have to do mixed shear and sidebar picking here. So let me just check the sidebar. It's a little springy. And the first thing I'm going to do is just check to see if any of the pins feel really bound up. And then I will try to rotate those. That was 6, didn't feel bad. Let's check 5. 5 doesn't feel bad. Okay, the slider is a little springy, but not a lot, so it's probably pretty close. That was 6. 5 is moving okay. Just figure out front ones. Front ones feel alright, but again, that slider prevents the sidebar from engaging with the front pins, so. Try to rotate pin 6. One, two, three, four, maybe a little bound up. 5 maybe. Okay, I'm gonna check the slider again. Okay, so I got a little bit of movement, which tells me that the slider dropped back and the sidebar engaged. So now I might still have to rotate some of the rear pins to the correct spot because the slider prevents the sidebar from falling on the front, but not the rear. So 6 is still really bound up, so I think I need to rotate that one a little bit. That was 5. 4 might need to rotate. That was 3. That was 1. Okay, some of these back ones still feel a little bound. So in the front, the pins are very loose. So that tells me that the front is set correctly. But I think one of these pins, maybe 4, needs to rotate. feels okay. Three feels okay. One feels okay. That was six, so I think that I needed to rotate. I'm hoping I didn't lose anything there. Three are set. Sidebar doesn't feel like it's going in correctly anymore. Still got a little bit of springiness to it, which maybe tells me that one of these front pins is not rotated anymore. It feels like it might be number two. Six needed to go a little bit. Six is went and four went. Five feels like it might be bound still. So I think I need to try to rotate five. That was six. That was five. That was four. The front three pins have really high lifts on them. That was three. That was one. just need to set one more pin. These are all really loose in here. Is that one? It's not set. Feel a lot of the pins in here are very jiggly, so it means that they are set correctly, both orientations to shear and to rotation. That was five. That feels like it rotated off. And pins in there. So my order is off. I think it's because four is not setting. Pin number four gives me a lot of difficulty in this lock. Okay. Everything is, again, really, really loose. Which tells me I'm pretty close here. Need a little pop. All right. So there you go. You can see the lock is picked. Now let's go ahead and get this real quick. I will cut the pin stacks through the top and then take the sidebar out. So just standard drivers, no mushroom drivers in any of these. You can see there's the gate, just true gates, no false gates in any of the key pins on this one. So hopefully when I was picking that, it was clear that even though I was going counterclockwise, I could not rotate everything correctly at once. I had to do a little bit of mixing. And again, I think it's partly because of the way the slider interacts with the sidebar. But also, I think it has to do with some of these longer key pens have this like spooled top that I think you can lift them and the spool gets caught on the sidebar. Hopefully you can see that there. So you can lift them and then they get stuck there, and then you can rotate them so that the gate touches the sidebar finger and it slides in, and then you can lift them the rest of the way. But that only really applies, I feel like, to the rearmost pens, because the front pens will not, if they're not rotated right, that slider will not go back at all. So I'm guessing that on those ones, once you get them rotated correctly, then the slider will drop, or will push back, the sidebar will drop in, and then those ones are basically rotationally correct for the rest of the pick. You can't rotate them out. Key here. Can hold the sidebar in and the slider. Okay, there's an anti-drill piece that popped out there. Not lose any of these little springs. Okay, so there's the slider, a little tiny spring in it. So see those bars right there block the sidebar from falling in until it's pushed back. Now, let's try not to drop any of these little tiny springs. One is still there in the core. So there's the sidebar. Focus. So you can see right there the fingers in the sidebar. And I'll bring up the whole tray. So there's the sidebar, the slider, there's all the pins. That's their gates. And then someone was showing one of these earlier, and they actually had, you can kind of see it, there's a little bit of, I don't know if that's serrating or some kind of counter milling on the top of, it looks like every chamber except for number 3. So I'm assuming that's also to catch the pins as they're being pushed up to shear. There you go, Medeco M3, picked and gutted. And now I have to put this whole thing back together. All right, thanks.